In the early 1990s, when she was 13, she was a standout cast member on the new Mickey Mouse Club TV show. Then she was in the hugely popular pop group, The Party. At 22, she starred on Broadway as Kim, the lead role in Miss Saigon. Today, she's the voice of Pearl in the mega-popular animated show Steven Universe, and her song parody group Mama Bears is a YouTube sensation. But before any of those amazing accomplishments, when she was just barely 13, she auditioned to be in my Just Say No musical, and I was floored. She's Dee Dee Lynn Magno Hall, and she's starred on many stages around the world, from TV to Broadway to YouTube.
Don't say yes, when you really, really mean no. It happens to me, it happens to you, I know how you feel.
Immediately after Dee Dee's audition, I was so excited. I ran up to her and said, I wrote this song. It's so special to me, and I would love it if you would sing it. The very next morning, she and I were sitting on her living room floor, and I taught her my song. Now, this is episode 11. Back in episode 7, I told the story of how, when I was on a bike trip, I wrote the song, It's Okay to Just Say No, which became Just Say No's theme song. Now, I've never told anyone this. But on that same bike trip, I wrote another song, which I self-plagiarized its melody from a McDonald's jingle I wrote a few years before.
McDonald's salutes you. McDonald's salutes.
I'm going to tell you all about that McDonald's jingle story in a bonus episode. But now, back to Dee Dee's story. After my bike trip, back in San Diego, I recorded the instruments to this new song, and I had this guy sing it. Now, he did a nice job, but it didn't have the special magic I was hoping for, and I wasn't totally happy with how I played the instruments either. So I recorded all new instrument tracks, and rather than me playing the piano, I asked a close friend of mine, an amazing pianist, to record the piano track. And now, the instrument tracks had the same magic that I felt when I wrote the song. Now I just needed to find the perfect person to sing it. So there I was, sitting with Dee Dee on her living room floor, about to teach her my song. I handed her the lyrics. Dee Dee, first, listen to the song with these old tracks and this fellow singing it.
We care about you. We care about you.
Then I played the new instrumental version. She listened very closely. It looked like she was, you know, silently singing it. When the song was over, she just sat there, quiet, staring at the lyrics. I couldn't tell what she was thinking. Did she understand the song's message? And even if she did, could she sing it with the same feeling and emotion it needed? After what felt like an eternity, she looked at me and said, Louis, I'm ready to sing it. Please play it again. When the song was over, we just sat there, looking at each other, speechless. Tears were welling up in my eyes, and I knew I was looking at a future star. I told her, Dee Dee, although we just met yesterday, I believe I wrote this song for you to sing. She looked at me smiled, and nodded in agreement. True story. A few days later, we went into the studio and she recorded We Care About You. It was her first professional recording session, and she sang it perfectly on the very first take. Dee Dee was a member of my Just Say No cast for about 10 months. She performed We Care About You many times at several venues, and each time she sang it with the same magic and feeling as the first time she sang it, sitting on her living room floor. In January 1989, we were about a month into rehearsals for the May premiere of my Just Say No musical stage play, when Dee Dee auditioned for Disney's reboot of the new Mickey Mouse Club TV show. I was not surprised that she was immediately cast. I was happy for her. She deserved this opportunity, but I was heartbroken to lose such a gifted singer and talented cast member. Without hesitation, I released Dee Dee from our production agreement because it was obvious she was destined to do great things and share her love and gift with so many people around the world. Today, Dee Dee is the voice of Pearl in the hugely popular animation series Steven Universe, and she's in lots of musicals and performs at many, many special events. She's also a member of the popular song parody YouTube sensation singing group, the Mama Bears.
I never knew a diamond could hurt so much.
And Dee Dee just launched the All Things Mighty show on YouTube with her best friend and former Mickey Mouse Club star, Mylan Brooks Stoddard. After Dee Dee left, I asked Danielle, who did such an amazing job singing Bodytalk, to step in and sing We Care About You. Here's the final version of We Care About You with Danielle.
Come on over, we all want you to be here.
We care about you, we care about you, and we always will. Please be good to yourself. Way too fast.
Now, you know why my song, We Care About You, and its message means so much to me, and how its young, gifted singer, Dee Dee Lynn Magno, went on to become a big star. But before she left, she gave me the greatest gift of all, singing We Care About You with the same love and feeling I had when I wrote it.
We care about you, we care about you, and we always will. Please be good to yourself.
Dee Dee and I remain friends to this day, and my daughter and I love going to see her in musicals. In an upcoming bonus episode, Dee Dee and I video chat about her experiences being an original Just Say No musical cast member. We'll also talk about her many TV, theater, and musical experiences and find out what projects she's working on now.
Sometimes you don't know what to do or where to turn to. Be patient. Good things will come to you if you want, and take your time, no need to hurry. Take some time, it will make a difference in your life. And we care about you, we care about you, and we always will. Please be good to yourself.
In the next, final, 12th episode in this series, I'm going to tell you about the two life-changing events that happened to me and how they set the course and the foundation for my creating Don't Say Yes When You Really Mean No. Both events happened when I was just 8 years old. One was this newfangled mechanical audio thingy, and the other was finding my surrogate family.